You know, 5 years ago, I'd have probably been hiding around the corner, and I don't want to answer that question. But, you know, I kind of did the research on it. That 3 ounce portion of beef that you've got from a hormone-free steer has 1.3 nanograms of estrogen in it. From an implanted steer with a hormone put in, it has 1.9 nanograms of estrogen in it. That baked potato you're going to have with that delicious 3 ounce portion of beef has 225 nanograms. My point is, there's other products that have a lot more estrogen in it.
Where do you think that idea is coming from? So we're putting hormones in milk. That's why girls are developing sooner.
Well, the short answer is no. It is not causing young girls to develop quicker. As I look at the population, one could certainly make the argument that a big part of it is too many calories. That for young children, that they are just eating too much, whether it's too much fat or too many calories, period. The long answer is, about 20 years ago now already, artificial growth hormone was used or was approved by FDA as a production enhancement tool. And it's essentially the same hormone as they produce normally to stimulate their milk production. They have to have a calf every year so that they can continue to give milk, and with the artificial growth hormone, they don't have to have a calf quite as often, and they can maintain higher production.
And not all cows get it. I mean, some cows, a dairyman would just naturally know that she cannot handle an increased production schedule. Some cows just, it works good on some cows, and other cows, just keep them off.
What happened within about the last 5 or 6 years, there was some consumer backlash against cows using, having that product injected. And as a result of that, a number of the grocers and processors basically said, we think that we can sell our milk more easily if we can label it without growth hormone. Even though there are no health risks or problems using it, and I personally have no problem drinking milk from animals that receive growth hormone. And I think the answer, is the milk safe, is a simple question. The answer, should consumers have a choice, I think is legitimate.
I want to know more about the hormones and all that kind of stuff, because in the past, I mean, I think I was kind of more concerned about that, not knowing as much information, and then I kind of slacked off a little bit, and then to hear the vet say that maybe it's a little bit more hype than it is truth, I thought was kind of interesting. You know, it's interesting to see how much the marketing puts into our head as opposed to coming here and seeing the real thing and what the truth is and being able to see that for yourself. It doesn't mean that I'm less concerned, it just means that I'm better educated.
Were you satisfied with the answer to the hormone question? I mean, did it satisfy your curiosity? And
I think it did to some extent. I mean, I think I would still, you know, like read some more and, you know, do a little bit of my own research and draw some of my own conclusions, because I think what's necessarily good for one person, you know, I mean, I think that's a reason why I've chosen to do something like this too, because I want to know what's right for me and what works for me, and you know, how I incorporate that with the knowledge that I have into my own life.